The cervical vertebrae are divided into two groups, typical cervical vertebrae from C3 to C4 and atypical cervical vertebrae from C1, C2 and C7. Typical cervical vertebrae include C3, C4, C5 and C6. That is the C6 cervical vertebrae. This is the inferior aspect of the C3 cervical vertebrae. Superior aspect of the C4 cervical vertebrae. Anterior aspect of the C4 cervical vertebrae. This is the superior aspect of the C4 cervical vertebrae. This one, superior aspect. So you can see, this is the anterior and this is posterior. So basing on that, we have the body, the body of C4. This is the vertebral body. Then we have this one. This one is called the uncinate process. So we have uncinate process. The left. This is the left. Then this is the right. Uncinate process. So as you go this side, you find that it is projected laterally from the transverse process, of which this is the transverse foramen. Foramen transversium. Then this okay. When you go, this is the superior articular process, having superior articular facet. Then the good posteriorly. So you can see here that anteriorly you have what you call the anterior part is called the pedicle part of the neural arch. The whole surface is the neural arch. This is the pedicle part of the neural arch, then this is the lamina part of the neural arch, then it's the posterior part, and this is the spinous process of C4 vertebrae. The anterior view of the C4 cervical vertebrae. So this is the vertebral body, all of this. You call it the vertebral body. Then you can see it as the transverse process is projected into tubercles. So you have this anterior tubercle and posterior tubercles. It's a tubercle, posterior tubercle, but together they form the transverse process. Here you have the transverse foramen transversium. Then you have what you call the superior articular process. Superior articular process having superior articular facet that face backwards, as we shall see. And this is articular surface on the uncinate processes. Uncinate processes have articular facet. Generally, typical cervical vertebrae have a broad and kidney-shaped body. Body is same size or smaller than the vertebral foramen. Anterior surface of the body is concave and then lost posterior piece pierced by basovertebral veins. The posterolateral surface on the superior articular surface projects into a lip called the uncus, which I showed you, which is the uncinate process. The transverse process is divided into anterior tubercle and posterior tubercle. Anterior tubercle enlarge progressively from C3 to C6 downwards. The C6 has the largest anterior tubercle, which is called the carotid tubercle of Kaisanganck. Carry even the foramen transversum are vertical to each other. The vertebral foramen is triangular in shape, a triangle. The superior articular facet face obliquely upward, up and back, while the lower articular facet face down and forward. Even the spines are bifid as they try to be vanishing. Then the processes are facet. A typical cervical vertebrae include C1, C2 and C7. This is C1. Superior view. C1 anterior view. C2 anterior view. C2 posterior superior view. C2 superior view. C7 superior view. The superior view of C1, which is called atlas. So this is the anterior tubercle. Then you have this process. That process has a groove. It has a groove somewhere for the vertebral artery. Then the superior articular surface. Superior articular surface. If you go this side, this is the we have the posterior tubercle somewhere. Yeah? But then this is the posterior arch. Posterior arch. This is anterior arch. Anterior arch. Anterior arch, so anterior arch, anterior arch, anterior tubercle, posterior arch, posterior arch, posterior tubercle, process having facets. Then as you go laterally, you find the transverse process having the foramen transversum or transverse foramen. The inferior view has it that this is the posterior tubercle. After turning like this, then this is anterior tubercle. So this is posterior, this is anterior. So this is the, you have the foramen transverse and this all here. Transverse foramen for vertebrae, this is inferior articular surface, this one. Appear to be kidney shaped also. Then this is articular surface for dens. Articular surface for dens. And there is the, okay, generally, okay, this is the vertebral foramen. This is the anterior view of axis, which is C2. So it has the dens. Dens has articular facet for anterior arch of the atlas. This dens is for articular surface of the atlas. So this area of the atlas comes and attaches like this. So you see? So anterior arch of this bone associating with this surface of the dens. So this is the vertebral body of C2. Then this is the superior articular surface, and in the same that way, this is the interarticular part. This one interarticular part. This is the inferior facet. There's an inferior facet designed. That one. Inferior facet of C2. This is posterior superior view of the axis. So this is the dens. Now it has a posterior. This is now a posterior articular facet for transverse ligament of the atlas. This is the interarticular part, interarticular process. Process. Then this is the spinous process of that C2. This is the superior view of the atlas of the axis bone. So you see, it has a dens. It has a dens. Then it has what you call the superior articular process facet. Inferior articular, they try to come out this side. Spinous process and then the transverse foramen. This is the superior view of C7. It has the body, it has the articular surface of which net process, it has the vertebral foramen, spinous process. This is the lamina, but this side anterior, you have pedicle, together they form the neural arch. You have the foramen transversum, the transverse foramen, that all transverse foramen. Then it has the pedicles, as I said, and spinous process. These are specific structures related to the atlas bone. So the atlas articulates with the axis below by two main joints, two types of joint. There is the atlanto occipital joint, which is a synovial joint. It is an articulating, articulating surface include the convex occipital condyles. And then, by this atlanto occipital joint is a joint between the atlas and the condyles. So these are the articulating surface together with the occipital condyles up there with the suture bones. The main joint between the atlas and the axis is the atlanto-axial joint. It consists of two. There's the median atlanto or atlanto-axial joint. So it's a joint between the arch on the anterior back on the anterior tubercle of the atlas and this articular surface, the anterior articular surface of the dens. It's a synovial joint. Synovial joint reinforced by the transverse ligament and this free movement aided by the iron cartilage and the synovial fluid. Also, the atlanto-occipital joint consists of the lateral atlanto-occipital joint. This exists between the inferior articular surfaces, those ones of the atlas, and the superior ones of the and the superior articular surface of the axis. So that joint does like this. So there is a lateral one this side and the lateral one basing on the side. So we have right and left, right and left. Lateral atlanto occipital joint, atlanto axial. All the joints are innervated by the C1 nerve. Other accessory ligaments include cross form ligament that runs with the transverse ligament at the body of the axis to the occipital bone. Then there's the tetorial membrane, which is the apex extension of the posterior longitudinal ligament. There's apical ligament. There's pair of other ligament. Anterior longitudinal ligament passes in between there. The vertebral column is posterior longitudinal ligament. There is a pair of ligamentum flava. Flava means yellowish ligament. The supraspinous ligament, which continues above as the mutual ligament in the cervical region, the interspinous ligament and vertebral intertransverse. The characteristics of the atypical cervical vertebrae here, that is for C7, for C1, again C1, C2 characteristics. Characteristics C2. The embryology of the vertebrae is from skeletal parts of mesoderm somites surrounding the notochord cord and needle tube in the mesoderm cheese. Caudal and cranial halves of the original somite fuse to form a ring of iron cartilage. Each ring now ossifies into three parts: the centrum or vertebral body, the lamina, which is the posterior part of the neural arch, and the pedicle, which is the anterior part of the neural arch. In week 8, ossification starts in the centrum and two halves of neural arch of fetal life during week 8. Hence, the three parts are united by cartilage. In year 1 after birth, the fusion of the two halves of neural arch fuse, but first in the lumbar as you move superiorly, so that means then to thoracic and finally the cervical region. In year 3, the centra unite with arches, first in cervical region and then thoracic. There is delay in the lumbar region. So in year 6, centra unite with neural arches in the lumbar region. Remember the other one has happened in year 3. Then the vertical cylindrical surfaces of body are covered with compact bone, except at the upper and lower surfaces where the body is covered by the iron cartilage. After puberty, body epiphyses appear as bony rings. The epiphyses are reached, but in early 20s, fusion of epithelial rings occur. Then, soon after birth, secondary centers appear: tipal spinous process, tipal transverse process, mammary process of T12 and other processes. This fuse in early 20s. Costrial mesocervical vertebrae fuse by direct extension from neural arch. Axis ossifies in week 7 of fetal life by center in each lateral mass. These centers around the posterior arch and united by year 4. But at year 1, the center appeared in anterior arch, the anterior arch faces, and the posterior arch faces. This is for the axis.